yet again we embark on a new journey, and this journey is going to be to a special place. It's raining and we are thrilled to go to Shivamogga. The idea was simple. We just had to get a cab and go to metro station. That's what we did, but the cab took 45 minutes to reach a place which was 2 kilometers from my apartments. And here we finally arrived at the metro station. We finally come to metro with lot of luggages all over us, and I hope we get a seat to sit, because we'll be traveling around 10 stops in metro. We'll be getting down at Ashwanpur and then joining our partners who are already waiting for us in the car. A thing about metro, it also goes through a lot of underground tunnels, and the cell reception there is terrible. Because of that, there was confusion in where we should get down and where they were waiting. First of all, we were late, and then second of all, this terrible confusion caused a lot of problem. But finally, we got down Ishwanpur. So finally out of metro, to cross this hell lot of a main road and bloody sound pollution. I hate this sound pollution. Right after we met them, we just started the journey. We didn't stop for lunch, we didn't stop for tea or coffee, because we wanted to reach the place. We finally came to that patch where it was all green on either sides of the road. That was amazing. You gotta see this. Finally, after 4 hours of travel, we are here on this state highway probably, or a village road. But the scenery, as you can see behind me, is amazing. Not a populated road here, but it's really good. Yes. So from here, we are directly going to Bhadravati, which is where we are going to eat some snacks again. The snacks here was pretty amazing. We never expected that taste to be here. I personally don't like having this street food much, but I love when it's full of quality. Taste coming out of it, the flavors. This place was almost as good as what it was explained to be. We really enjoyed. Then after dinner, we arrived at this hotel, which was good. We finally arrived at this hotel here. It's called Padma Residency. Oh, it's a good hotel. Finally, I must say, the room is really good. It's clean, it's spacious. Two things that we really look for in a room. To call it a night, I think this is an ideal place. Good night. I mean, it's my night, and it's either a good day, good evening, or good night, depending on when you're watching it. But have a tremendous life. So you finally come into this room. I'll just take you on a short tour of this room. Look around. It's a good hotel. Chinu is there in the mirror. He's actually sitting behind here. We love the room. The mirror is very broad. We have a TV here and a good bed and a spacious room. We like the room. And now a little perspective about today. You know, we always travel like nomadic people. I don't know which part of my DNA has these nomadic genes, which actually came through our ancestors probably. But because of me, all of them were traveling. Today is a little different. we have come to visit Aditya's hometown, Bhadravati. And around this place, this is called Are Malnad. Means, not exactly like Malnad, but half of Malnad. A brief about Malnad. Malnad is a place on the western part of Karnataka, which is very close to Western Ghats. It receives a lot of rainfall close to the Arabian Sea. So, it is humid, it is wet, and it is awesome. That's Malnad. And Are Malnad means half of it. So this place is like half of everything I just explained. It receives very good rain, it has good rivers, temple, everything that is natural. Our plan for tomorrow is to go and visit place where Rashtrakavi Kuvempu was born. It's called Tirthalli, and then Bhadra Reservoir, a dam. Day after tomorrow will be very, very interesting. I would definitely share it with you.